Students, this is Dr. Badrinath. Yeah, drug addiction, abuse, tolerance, and dependence. That is today's topic. Here, the drug means not the morphine, not the cocaine, not the heroin, not. So, drug is medicine here. Medicine means drug here in this chapter. Okay, right. And some people know they will take the drugs like peppermints, chocolates, or candy, orange candy, like that. They will eat regularly drugs. It is a regular habit. Morning 10 tablets, afternoon 10 tablets, and evening 10 tablets. Whenever they want, they are taking tablet unnecessarily. So that is a topic here. Drug addiction, drug abuse, drug tolerance, drug dependence. See, totally four terms are there. All are confusing. It seems very confusion. Okay, I will give one clarification here. Almost drug addiction and drug dependence, both are same. Need not to be read it separately. Keep in your mind. First one, drug addiction. First one. Drug dependence, last one. Are same, almost same. Okay, not exactly, but difference is not negligible. Okay, need not to be worried about that. Drug addiction is nothing but drug dependence only. How to remember means here double D will come in this addiction. Here also dependence, DD will come, double D will come. So drug addiction, drug dependence, both are same. So both DD, here you can find, you cannot find the D letter. Here also you cannot find the D letter, abuse and tolerance, right? Okay. And you can see the one here, one gundu boss like me here in this photograph. See here, he is feeling very happy whenever there was a fall of the medicine. He is taking a bath also just from the, with the medicine. Okay, medicines are falling from the sky. He is feeling very happy, just like a rain. Okay, that much of dependence is there. That much of misusing, that much of addiction is there. Not only this boss, this gundu boss, and also his shade also. See here, his shade also feeling really happy. His soul or his shade, whatever it may be, his soul also feeling very happy. Drug. That is a medicine, right? So, we are studying a subject of pharmacology 1, that is a theory part, very important subject, you know very well, and we came to the last part of the total subject, that is unit 5 as per the syllabus of Pharmacy Council of India. But however, this is very important for all medical and paramedical students. See here, you can see the all four different terms in the syllabus, last topic of the total subject: drug addiction, drug abuse, drug tolerance, drug dependence. Total four are there. Drug dependence, drug addiction, both are same. So under one heading only you can read it. So totally 1, 2, 3 headings are there. That's it. Yeah, what are the drugs? Here the drug means not morphine, heroin, cocaine, no. You keep aside. Those drugs are different. Okay. Here the drug is any substance except the food and water. Drug is nothing but any substance. Okay. Excluding the food, excluding the water, which when taken into the body, it alters the body's function. Body's function, either it is a biochemistry parameters or whatever it may be, any some of the parameter or enzymes or whatever it may be, it alters the body's function either physically or mentally, that is psychologically. So either physically or psychologically or both, it may do both also. Okay, that is about the drug. First we will see the drug abuse. We know about the misuse. What is the drug use? Misuse means we know very well in regular our regular language we are using that misuse. Okay, what is the abuse? See here, if you abuse the drugs, see here this very wonderful cartoon, and if you abuse the drug, they will abuse you. What is this abuse? That we will see. See, he is taking a syringe and medicine. He is abusing drugs. Okay, that much of he is taking. Yeah. Drug abuse. It is nothing but misuse of a drug, unnecessary use of the drug. You are calling it as a drug abuse. Simple word we are using. Unnecessary, unwanted use of the medicine. Misuse of the medicine. For example, say misuse of CNS stimulants like a caffeine. Caffeine tablets or coffee, a CNS depressants, which depresses the CNS. See, a person is always in the depression. So he went to a doctor. The doctor has wrote some CNS stimulants. So what happened? 10 tablets the doctor has wrote. So daily one tablet he will take. So he will feel his CNS stimulant is 11th day, 12th day, there is no tablets. But what he will think is, again he will show the same prescription to the medical shop. He will start purchasing of the 10 tablets again. 10 tablets. And he will start using of it without doctor permission for the second time. Doctor has wrote only the course of 10. Okay, because he will feel that if I will not take again, I may go depression. Why? Instead of that simply tablet, I will take like that. So most of the misusing is done in CNS stimulants, CNS depressants. Using of levocitrizine. Actually, levocitrizine is allergy. See here, allergy, levocitrizine. Dextro also there. Dextro is inactive. Only levocitrizine is very active. Levorotatory, dextrorotatory, that we know very well. Using for the allergy, side effects are, these side effects are the drowsiness and sleepy. So you will get a sleep. If you are taking a levocitrizine, you will feel a very drowsy. But people, instead of for allergy, some people, if they are not getting a sleep, they are taking levocitrizine. They will take a citrizine and they will sleep well. Because drowsiness, they are taking a tablet here for the side effect, not for the main therapeutic effect. Just imagine how the people are developed. See, they are more than the paramedical staff, they are more than the doctors, they are more than the pharmacists. Okay, right. So usage of the drugs for non-therapeutical purpose also comes under abuse. Non-therapeutical purpose to alter the mood. If you want to change the mood, you take a tablet. So you are taking a tablet or you are changing the mood. Okay, to alter the consciousness. Okay, for bodybuilding. Caffeine, morphine, heroin, all these they are taking, not for therapeutic. Actually, morphine and heroin are very good, excellent painkillers, analgesic, but that we know very well. But they are not taking for a painkiller, as a painkiller. They are using for the non-therapeutical purpose, to change the mood, especially some of the big celebrities. They are taking this morphine, heroin, big celebrities. Some of the big celebrities, they are taking these drugs, okay? To change the mood, to feel very happy. They will feel that they are in the heaven, like that. Temporarily, that is also temporary, okay? Like caffeine, morphine, heroin. It produces a drug-seeking behavior. This drug abuse, if you are taking a misusing non-therapeutically purpose you are taking, your behavior will be changed. Your behavior, I want the drug, like that you will be changed. So this property is called as a reinforcing property. It is a starting stage of the problem. This drug abuse is the starting. Later, it goes to the drug addiction, everything and all. First bad stage is the drug abuse. If you are using it properly, it is very good. If you are not using it properly, it may lead to drug addiction. So behavioral problems starts from here. That is the main problem. So they will start behavior, it will be different. Whenever drug is not there, their behavior will be changed. Okay, right. So drug dependence, I already told, it is also called as a drug addiction. Double D is a keyword here. D will come. So what is this drug dependence and drug addiction? See that he completely depended on the drug. So he is feeling very bad because it is not full of tablets. This, it consists of only 10 to 15 tablets, 10 tablets around that. It is not full. So he is feeling very dull because that much of he depended on the drug. Repeated use of the drug. Periodically you are using a drug, continuously using of a drug, it is called as a drug addiction or drug dependence. Using it repeatedly, how many times? Craving to take the drug, craving, like whenever you miss the breakfast, you are feeling very hungry to take the lunch. That's here also same that craving is also here. Drug, I want the drug. So many self-gratifying drug seekers inhale the volatile substances that affect the CNS. Some of the drug substances like a paint solvent, nail polish remover, whitener, so they are taking it, okay, to affect their CNS, to stimulate the CNS. Two types of things are there here, drug dependence, physical dependence like alcohol and psychological dependence. Psychological dependence means here the mind will say, to take the drug, like a smoking, CNS stimulants, like amphetamine, very important, amphetamine. These are the, here, mind will say, to take the medicine. Whereas a physical dependence, here the body will say, to take the medicine. Here alcohol is the best example. Here the alcohol, body will say, to take the alcohol. to take the alcohol. Body will say, here mind will say. And third one is the last one, drug tolerance. Drug tolerance. Tolerance means one tablet is not enough. That's why he purchased one complete bottle. One complete bottle is not enough. So that's why he purchased four, because not working. One tablet not working. So he is taking a 10 tablet. 10 tablets are not working. He is taking a one tablet because already he is using, daily using. So the body has got tolerated. This property is called as a drug tolerance. See here, he, even though he is taking a four bottles of a tablet, it is not working. That's why he grabbed four tablet. That is the thing, drug tolerance. Upon the repeated use of the drugs, repeated use, repeated administration, repeated use, a decreased effect of drug is seen. That is called a definition one, drug dependence, drug tolerance. A large doses of a drug is needed in this case to obtain the same effect as the previous dose, especially the antibiotics. They got resistant microbial organisms will be resist to the tablet. So the unnecessarily, if you are taking, this is the scenario. Okay, types of tolerance, like cross tolerance is there, acute tolerance is there, cross tolerance, acute tolerance, and acquired tolerance is there. Cross tolerance means once the tolerance to the primary drug develops. See here, morphine and heroin, I will tell you the example so that you can understand. Morphine, if you are taking regularly, like a 1 gram, 2 gram, 3 gram, 4 gram, next what happened, these 1, 2, 3, 4 will not work. Directly you have to take a 10 grams. Directly you have to take a 20 grams. That means we know that is a drug tolerance. In the cross tolerance, what happened? He habituated to take up to 5 grams of a morphine. Now he taken a 5 grams of heroin directly, but it will not work. Because body is habituated to morphine, at the same time, it will get a tolerance to the heroin also. Okay, so directly he has to take a 10 grams of the heroin. Then only heroin will start working on it. Alcohol and benzodiazepine, this is one combination. Morphine and heroin is one combo. Whenever you are taking a morphine, heroin also will get a tolerance. And whenever he is taking alcohol, benzodiazepines also will get a tolerated. Okay, like that you can remember. Acute tolerance. Acute means small, for a small time. Tolerance will be there here, but only for a smaller period. Suppose you have taken a one tablet today. Tomorrow you are taking one tablet, it will not work. Two tablets you have to take. Day after tomorrow, no, you have to take a 3 tablets, but it will be there for only for a period of a 1 week or 1 month. Later, if you give a gap, your tolerance will be reduced again. Okay, it will be good. Again, you can be start with the 1 tablet again after giving a gap of 1 month. So this is acute tolerance, means tolerance will be there, but only for a smaller period. You have to take a number of medications, then only it will work. But after giving a gap, 1 month or 2 months, 3 months, again, you can start with the only one tablet, that will happily it works, no problem. So tolerance will be there for only for a short period of a time, like a sympathomimetic, so catecholamines, amphetamine. That's why doctors will prescribe here 1 month and give a gap like a 2 months, and again they will drop. Some of the courses are like that only. Acquired tolerance, it is divided into 3 types, like a pharmacokinetic, enzyme induction, enzyme inhibition will be there, like that, pharmacodynamic, and learner tolerance. 3 are much, details are not important. Okay, so last slide, we came to the management, like what you had to do, substitution therapy. So by similar drug you can be give, but similar drug, the drug, whatever you are giving a drug in, for example, patient is taking a drug A. So doctor has to think it. So he is taking A drug regularly. Why I have to, there may be a chance of addiction. So doctor will prescribe the B. B is also having a same therapeutic effect, but B is having a long half-life. Longer half-life. So daily 1 tablet is enough. Or 2 days once tablet is enough. Like that, longer half-life drug they will prescribe. That is one of the management of that. And aversive therapy, antagonist drug, antagonist, that is means agonist, anti-craving drugs. I told you, I want the drug, anti-craving drug also there. Rehabilitation center, like a socio psychosocial intervention. All these are the some of the things, but not much important. But keep in your mind only four headings. Okay. So I will end my session here. Keep watching in my channel playlists. There you can find all my videos.